Assalamu alaikum. Today I'm going to discuss the pituitary gland and they are controlled by the hypothalamus. Almost all the major glands of the body are controlled by hypothalamus. Pituitary is located just below the hypothalamus. It has two distinct parts two distinct regions or the portions. Collectively it is known as hypophysis. The pituitary gland is also known as hypophysis, and it has a diameter of above 1 cm and it is 0.521 gram in the width. So you can see here it is a very small gland, but it is the master gland of the body. It is major functions of the body are controlled by pituitary gland. Now what is the location of pituitary gland? It lies in the cella thoracica, a bony cavity at the base of the brain, and is connected to the hypothalamus by the pituitary or hypophyseal stalk. This structure I will discuss you with the help of a diagram. Actually, this is the hypothalamus and this is the pituitary gland. This is the posterior pituitary gland and this is the anterior pituitary gland. The region which separates the anterior pituitary gland to the posterior pituitary gland is known as pars intermedia, and this is the region known as cella thoracica, and this is the region of the sphenoid bone. Sphenoid bone is present just behind the high orbital. This is the base of the brain cavity. Cella thoracica is present here. And this stalk is the hypophyseal stalk, which is the connection between the hypothalamus and the pituitary gland. Now the next point is to discuss here, what is the embryonic origin of the pituitary gland? Anterior pituitary gland is originated from rachte pouch, which is an embryonic invagination of the pharyngeal slits. That's why its nature is of epithelium type, and posterior pituitary gland is embryologically originated from the neural portion of the hypothalamus. So the cells present in it are of glial types. Six important types of peptide hormones, they have less or more effect on the body of the animal, are secreted by the anterior pituitary gland, and two important peptide hormones are secreted by the posterior pituitary gland. Actually, these are not actually secreted by the posterior pituitary gland, but these are released by the nerve endings in the hypothalamus, and posterior pituitary gland stores it for time being and then secreted when these hormones are needed. There are six types of hormone: growth hormone, adrenocorticotropin hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone, prolactin hormone, antidiuretic hormone, and the oxytocin. Last two hormones, antidiuretic hormone and oxytocin, these belong to the posterior pituitary, and upper hormones belong to the anterior pituitary. Growth hormone promote the growth of the entire body. All other hormones affect their specific target cells, but the growth hormone affects each and every cell of your body by multiplying the cells, increasing the mitosis or increasing the protein deposition. Adrenocorticotropin control the secretion of some of the adrenocortical hormones, which affect the metabolism of the glucose, proteins, and fats, etc. Adrenocorticotropin hormone affects the adrenal gland, which is present just above the kidney, and the hormones of this gland are involved in the glucose, protein, and fats regulation. I will discuss it in very detail in the chapter of the adrenal gland. Next is the definitely thyroid stimulating hormone. It affects the T3 and the T4, and these hormones almost control the whole body functions. Prolactin, it promotes the mammary gland development and milk production. two separate gonadotropin hormones, follicle stimulating hormone, abbreviated as FSH in the capital, and the luteinizing hormone LH. These control the growth of the ovaries and the testes as well as their hormonal and reproductive functions. Now these are the two hormones that belong to the posterior pituitary. These are the antidiuretic. Another name of the antidiuretic hormone is the vasopressin. It controls the rate of the water excretion into the urine, thus helping to control the concentration of the water in the body fluid. This hormone is especially important during the conditions of the water secrecy or during the condition of the dehydration. Oxytocin, it helps to express the milk or rejection of the milk from the mammary gland, and it possibly helps in the delivery of the baby at the end of the gestation. Anterior pituitary contain various types of the cells, and each cell is modified for secreting specific type of the hormone. This will be discussed with the help of this table. Somatotrophs, the word trophs is used for the cell. It releases the hormone that is growth hormone, abbreviated as GH or the somatotrophin. Chemistry and the physiological actions, these are specifically important in your syllabus, so you have to focus on these 2 points too. It is a single chain of 191 amino acids. What are the its physiological effects? It stimulates the body growth, stimulates the secretion of IGF-1, insulin. IGF-1 is insulin-like growth factor, stimulates lipolysis, breakdown of the lipids, inhibits the action of the insulin on the carbohydrate and lipid metabolism. Definitely, insulin is responsible for the storing of glucose into the liver. Next type of cells are the corticotropics. Adrenocorticotropic hormone or ACTH is released from the corticotropes. And its chemistry is it is a single chain of the 39 amino acid. It stimulates the production of the glucocorticoids. Glucocorticoids are the hormones, as from the name indicate, these glucocorticoids are involved in the glucose regulation, and the androgens by the adrenal cortex. Although androgens are produced by the adrenal gland, but they don't have any kind of strong effect in the body. Androgens hormones are really involved in the maintenance of secondary sexual characteristics. It maintains the size of the zona fasciculata and zona reticularis of the cortex. These are the actually two regions of the adrenal gland. I will discuss these in detail in the chapter of the adrenal gland. Next cells are the thyrotrophs. And they release thyroid stimulating hormone TSH. It is a glycoprotein. Its main it is a mixture of carbohydrate and the protein. It has two subunits, alpha and the beta. Alpha unit contain 89 amino acids and the beta unit contain 112 amino acids. It stimulates the production of thyroid hormone by thyroid follicular cells. It maintains size of the follicular cells. It stimulates the development of ovarian follicles, regulates spermatogenesis in the testes. Okay, next cells are the gonadotrophs, and these release follicle stimulating hormone and the luteinizing hormone. Both these hormones are the glycoproteins, and these have two units, alpha and beta subunits. Alpha units contain 89 amino acids in both, while in case of beta unit, FSH contain 112 amino acids and beta unit contain 115 amino acids. It stimulates the development of ovarian follicle. It regulates spermatogenesis in the testes. It causes ovulation of the formation of the corpus luteum in the ovaries. It stimulates the production of estrogen and progesterone by the ovaries. It stimulates testosterone production by the testes. Next is the lactotrophs. Lactotrophs or mammotrophs or IGF insulin-like growth factor. These are involved in the release of the prolactin hormone. The prolactin hormone consists of a single chain of 198 amino acids, and it stimulates the milk secretion and production from the mammary gland.